What is going on, everyone? Nostalgia 925 coming at you with another Digimon Digivolution Line video. Boy, there is so much to talk about. In Digimon Adventure 2020, it appears that this series is not just a remake, but rather a reboot with new Digimon. And new Digimon means that we will have to discuss all of them and see how they fit within the overall Digimon narrative. There are no spoilers, well, maybe aside of the fact that Metal Greymon has a new mode, but there are no spoilers, so you are safe to watch it even though you haven't seen the series, like myself. What we are going to do here is take a look at the new form, or rather, a new mode of Metal Greymon, also called Metal Greymon Alterus mode. We basically see a Metal Greymon but with huge technological upgrades. In comparison to Metal Greymon, the technology it has looks more finished, more complete. So, in order to better understand Metal Greymon Alterus mode, we'll have to get back to Metal Greymon a bit, just to put things into perspective. One of the conditions for a Greymon to digivolve into Metal Greymon would be that it fights its way through and defeat the formidable opponents who come against it. That is the main condition that would basically trigger the Metal Empire genes, as I like to call it, that would mechanize a little more than half of its body with technology appropriated from Andromon. Even though fighting is one of the main conditions, there seem to be a difference in Greymon power depending on their geographical locations. In the Metal Greymon vaccine profile, it is written that the Metal Greymon of Folder Continent are cyborg Digimon that succeed in perfectly digivolving from Greymon and draw out a stronger power which cannot be compared with those of File Island. Now, this phrase can be interpreted in various ways, and you'll see, depending on the location we are talking about, it should make more sense to see Metal Greymon's Alterus form, but let me briefly explain what those places are all about. The Folder Continent, where Metal Greymon is stronger, is said to be a harsh environment. It is the only habitat of Veedramon, a Digimon with offensive power that is uncommon even among champions. Digimon who grow up there are so strong that File Island Digimon cannot compare. What's a bit weird is that, despite the display of power by Digimon inside Folder Continent, it is in File Island that you have the stories of Digimon Adventure, the same area that is guarded by the Harmonious Ones. Now, depending on how harsh an environment is and how many battles Greymon had fought, it will digivolve into a Metal Greymon with different fighting capabilities. What is said about Metal Greymon's Alterus mode is that with the accumulation of fierce battles that it has lived through, it transformed its right arm into a huge energy cannon called Alterus, so that it can fight against tough enemies that draw near. So basically this would mean that Metal Greymon Alterus mode is an upgraded Digimon based on adaptation. It had to fight more battles, tougher battles than those of Folder Continent, and Metal Greymon desperately needed some adaptation, and some of you pointed out its flaws, like the following. Metal Greymon has numerous problems with its design. It is slow and cumbersome, it has slow response time, its flight speed is also very slow, and even though it can fly, it has very little mobility in the air, making the flight not viable for combat. That is according to Andres Marrero. Also, originally Metal Greymon had more of a slouched dinosaur-like posture, but since entering Alterus mode, Metal Greymon now has a more human stance, where it stands much more straight up. Also, I believe that Metal Greymon Alterus mode is the natural progression from Metal Greymon because originally it altered its body with technology in order to gain more battle power, so it makes sense that when Metal Greymon would find it is needing more power, it would turn to the method. And that is by the King 901. Now these are very nice comments, and I will have to say the following about the King 901's comment. There is this article here written by BM Contributor, you'll find a link towards it in the description box. The name of the article is one with an interesting question. It says the following, a new form between Ultimate and Mega. It also talks about the Sagittarius mode, but that is for another video. I will read a quote coming from the article. I quote, "The new show has officially introduced a new form or mode that bridges the gap between Ultimate and Mega level Digimon." To this quote, I would say yes and no, and I would even go as far as to say mostly no. To bridge the gap means that you try to connect two things or to make the difference between them smaller. So let me say the following, we are comparing Metal Greymon Alterus mode to which other Mega level Digimon. We can indeed assume that the difference between a Metagraemon Ultros mode and a War Greymon should be smaller, as Metagraemon Ultros mode is designed to be the better version of Metagraemon. But first of all, you have to know that in Digimon, the more something is rare, like an ultimate level Digimon and definitely a mega level Digimon, the stronger that rare Digimon will be in comparison to its entire line. And Digivolving is not just a metamorphosis, it is a Digimon changing in appearance and abilities based on experience, based on adaptation, based on whatever gene they have that will define their abilities and appearance by a large margin. You do not have this change when a Digimon changes mode, meaning that a Digimon with its mode change could not or should not, we never know how the Digimon developers will write their stories, but an ultimate Digimon who changes modes should normally not be able to bridge the gap with a mega level Digimon, because the power multiplier from ultimate to mega exceeds by far that of an ultimate changing modes. If you have ever watched the Dragon Ball franchise, it would be the same as saying that a Super Vegeta, who was in his Super Saiyan 1 form but in a different mode, is stronger than a Vegeta Super Saiyan 2. That would be wrong, and on that front I would say that Digimon works the same. There's a reason why we make a distinction between ultimate and mega, or officially translated, perfect to ultimate. And by the way, just to continue on the close the gap premise, there is a reason why I take issue with it. I just said that if we are closing the gap in power between the ultimate Metagraemon in its Ultros mode, that we need to find a suitable mega level Digimon to compare it. And I believe that War Greymon would not immediately be suitable, because if there is an Ultros mode, an enhanced version, that would mean that the mega level that would come out of Metagraemon Ultros mode would have evolved based on these enhancements. Would that bring us to an alternate mega level, just like the article pointed out? And my answer would be, it should. Some pointed out to Victory Greymon, which is a good pick, even though I might have some minor small issues with this pick, simply because character profile wise, Victory Greymon is a bit different. Others gave their opinion about what should be a mega level of Metagraemon Ultros mode, and let me quote. For me, Metagraemon Ultros mode represents both an antithesis of Rise Greymon, as it has a sword for arm instead of Rise Greymon's arm cannon, but also represents a kind of inheritance of Kaiser Greymon's sword, that is, by Sergio Duran. Another comment says the following: many are saying that this mode leads to Machinedramon due to the events in the 2020 reboot, but Machinedramon just uses Metagraemon's trident arm. Another idea that has been proposed in the Digimon fandom is that this form and events eventually lead to Blitz Greymon, which makes sense, by Andres Marrero. To finish, there's the last one. Ultros Metagraemon will digivolve to Shine Greymon by Yon Siegfried. These are very interesting theories. We will find out what will happen next. The point of this video is to learn more about the Ultros form, rather than knowing what will happen next in Digimon Adventure 2020. And speaking of, let us talk about its upgrades. What makes Metagraemon Ultros mode more different than a regular Metagraemon? Here is a good quote that summarizes the enhancements. I quote, "The way I see Metagraemon Ultros mode is a further boost to Metagraemon's combat abilities in both long range and close range by further mechanizing its body while still retaining previous mechanizations to allow it to fight tougher and stronger opponents," by Might Dino. Very true. This Metagraemon variant has so much up its sleeve. The fact that a Metagraemon can now fight both in close and long range is already very interesting. And in addition to what Metagraemon has, it can now, in its Ultros mode, use the energy cannon to convert the energy it has accumulated into a Positron blade. Positron is also used by Imperildramon. I could explain how dangerous it is, but I might as well explain that in the Explaining Digimon Attack series, a series I quite frankly forgot I even began with. You can find its playlist in the channel. Metagraemon Ultros mode can send out high temperature energy wave from the firing ports on its chest, or fire concentrated energy and fire subliminal bombardments. Clearly it has enough tools to better defend itself against tougher opponents. Francis O'Neill wrote the following: "Damn, that hidden X antibody finally kicked in. About time." For those who are new, the X antibody is a vaccine that makes Digimon immune to the X program, and with COVID-19 we might also need a reliable vaccine that makes us immune to it. Anyway, the X program is basically an elimination program to kill Digimon. I would love to make a video about it, considering how many times I mentioned it. The beauty about the X antibody is that it makes the Digimon who has it, once used, more powerful than their normal counterparts. And many species of Digimon are natural carriers of the X antibody, even though its influence will only manifest once the vaccine is being used. Now, when we look at Metagreymon X, meaning a regular Metagreymon that used the X antibody, it does not quite look like the Altruis mode. However, when we look at the Metagreymon X variant that was infected by the Black Digitron, we can see the same Altruis weapon. And Kenji Watanabe, the one who designed the Altruis mode, based the looks on the darker X variant, leaving us poor souls with other question marks. Now here is another quote from that one article. There is also the X antibody virus type factor of it all. This is an element of Digimon that has not been in the mainline anime before, but in some of the games, there is a thing called the X antibody that creates alternate forms of certain Digimon. There is Metagreymon Virus X and Weregarurumon X, and there are even more, but the point is the similarity. Now, aside of the many questions you may have, I would say that your answers will normally be answered once the series progresses, hopefully. So I'm not going to try and give theories about that. What I can do, however, is put Metagreymon Virus X next to Altruis mode. I did talk about the difference between the Altruis mode of Metagreymon in comparison to Wargreymon to see who is more powerful. When I looked at Metagreymon Virus X's profile, I might also have to say that Metagreymon Virus X is more powerful than the Altruis mode for two reasons, actually three. One, it has the X antibody boost. 2. It has the Black Digitron boost, which is a mysterious secretion that if mixed with a Digimon, their power will increase, their color will get darker, and may have some other possible side effects. And 3. This is but a theory, it looks like the combination of Black Digitron and the X antibody might have been at the origins for such a strong update that you see in Metagreymon Virus X, because Metagreymon X has not the same updates, far from it. While Metagreymon Altruis mode gives a Metagreymon access to the Altruis weapon, Metagreymon Virus X has that weapon by default, and that same weapon has two more modes, namely the Blitz mode and the Blast mode. With the Blast mode, it can fire viral energy. With the Blitz mode, it can fly at critical velocity and pierce the enemy, infecting them with an infectious virus that is toxic enough to be designated as a disaster. It can completely corrode the configuration data within the Digicore, even if it is simply scratched. And mind, Metagreymon Virus X has been equipped with an energy booster that, at its maximum output, could let it exceed the speed of sound. Now, it is another debate whether Metagreymon could survive the speed of sound. You know, I have always loved studying and read about poison. It might be a bad habit, I don't know, but there is a reason why chemical weapons who are poisonous, to say the least, are prohibited in warfare. I studied, and worse, I saw why its use is forbidden by the chemical weapon convention. A Digimon that can fly very fast and use poison is a big threat. It's like facing a venomous snake that can fly very fast and spread its poison. So Metagreymon Virus X to me is certainly the most lethal out of the three others. Now to finish, there were some of you angel faces who were not immediately pleased with Metagreymon Altruis mode. I will read three of your comments. I like Metagreymon by giving a cannon to a Digimon who have grappler arms and inbuilt cannon launchers. Seriously, it should have some lore, like how Chrome Digizode is more than just a simple metal, by a day 20. I don't like it, it's ugly and impractical. Yes, even for anime, it looks like a sword, stretches like a whip, and shoots like a laser, by Elvin Wolf 2. I don't like it. I don't want to seem like I'm appealing to nostalgia, which is me, or anything of that nature. However, to me, it seems that it was just made to be flashy and cool and pure fan service. Two fans of adventure by Silver Sapphire 5. To tell you the truth, I'm very happy that you guys give your opinions about whether you like or do not like the new mode. Ultimately, it is thanks to criticism that we can make good content or progress. So in other words, you not liking it is just as important as the opinions of those who do like it. And there are more than enough aspects in Digimon that I find could have been different, way different. As long as your thoughts are well elaborated in texts with arguments and, out of preference, no dirty words aimed towards those who do not agree with you, I'm all good. And I will feel even better when all opinions here that might go against yours are respected and that people feel at ease to just talk and say what they have in mind. We are smart and we're all Digimon fans, so let us be a proper community with manners. There is a comment written by someone named Hurler. Unfortunately, I cannot really show it because of spoilers, but it was a comment who said that some Digimon villains were heavily underutilized. Some might have been real threats who pulled the strings in the background, and yet they ended up being killed sometimes at their first encounter, which does not make sense if you really were to take into account their profile or what they would embody. Like Devimon, for example, who is the literal embodiment of the devil. You would expect that it would get an even bigger role, and yet we don't really seem to get that, and that is one of the biggest things that bother me in the Digimon franchise, so I have to agree with Hurler on this one, and that is just to let you know that even I have a lot of things in the Digimon franchise that I dislike. Now guys, this is the end of the video, I hope you enjoyed it. Make sure to write down in the comment section how you feel about Metal Greymon Ultras mode. I'm also very happy to see that the Digimon developers are serious with the reboot. We are seeing new Digimon who are exciting, for now. So I'm curious to see what they have in stock, even though I admit I have yet to watch the series. It's just that my life at this point is a bit troublesome, you will get the details in the video. The only thing I can do for you at this point is provide you with weekly content. I said I was going to do that, so I'm keeping myself to my word, even though I fail from time to time, in fact many times. Oh, and a real thank you to my Patreon brothers and sisters. I promise I will explain in a separate video how you guys have helped me through these challenging times. Make sure to subscribe to the channel, you just need to press on that red subscribe button, if it is still red. And make sure to like and drop a comment. I always end up screenshotting and put it on the Instagram page. I have about 50 or more that I will post, I'm just a bit late on schedule at this point. Also, there is a Discord link in the description box. If you feel like talking to more people about Digimon, head over there. For those who are new, all Digimon videos are placed in particular playlists, which are always updated. So if you want to catch up on the videos, make sure to head over there.